finding any motivation has been really difficult, and I don't think I'm alone in that. So I want to make a little video today talking about how I'm pressing through this bizarre state of affairs right now. We've been in this, you know, quarantine for over 4 weeks now, and it's getting boring. I'm getting restless. Finding motivation to keep working, to keep moving forward is tough, but I'm finding it. And it's not like a magic formula or anything. It's pretty simple, and that's what I want to try to share today. But first thing I have to do, it's Monday, it's off hours, it's not quite first thing in the morning, it's second thing in the morning, and I gotta do groceries. Garage workout, check. How I'm finding this, or tapping into this motivation in these uncertain times and strange times, is a book I read basically a week or two into this. Just, it was my next in my list. It was called The One Thing. Linked it below on Amazon. The principle there is just like, you have to kind of find your one thing, and then how do you plan your time to make sure you work on your one thing every day very intently. The idea is you schedule an appointment with yourself every day to work on your one thing. Distraction-free, intently focused work on your one thing, and whatever your one thing is, it could be school, it could be work, startup, your fitness, your golf, whatever it is, like that's up to you. I've found it very, very helpful because I've always planned out my weeks, but it's very easy when there's kind of nothing at the end of this. It's just like, oh, okay, we'll roll with it, and the weeks, the days will change. But on Sunday, I sit down, give myself like half an hour, and I plan out the whole week. And at the start of this, it was very easy to do because I was filming a lot, trying to get ahead of the curve and have a lot of videos to put out. So my one thing in the start of this whole quarantine was just to sit and edit, film, plan, and just like knock that out in the morning. I have a little note checklist and I check it off. So like a day like today, I planned this whole week out, and today was like, okay, you gotta wake up, things you need to do. You have to edit a music video I'm working on, get those groceries done, get your workout done. This is my one thing today. It's maintenance work, but then that allows me time to practice, and that's what this afternoon is. It's practice time. It's not film time. It's practice time. And yeah, film vlog time, but it's not go out on the golf course and film a course vlog or anything like that. It's practice time. It's time for me to work on my game, because all I can handle and control is the process right now. And the process is my effort on my golf game. When this all ends, a month from now, 2 months from now, whenever, I want to be able to play tournament golf and be sharp. So I can't just sit and rest on my laurels. I need to put in some focused, mindful, intentional work every day. That's my one thing. Writing it down, planning it out, and just crossing it off, there's a sense of accomplishment that you fall in love with that. And that book has really helped me. Just do it. You just got to show up. Set those appointments with yourself and just show up. That's the key. If you're struggling to practice because you don't see why you should practice, well, just go to the golf course and you'll figure it out. Show up, get off your ass. That's kind of what I'm having to do to myself and today, and that's why I think I'm vlogging it, just to keep myself accountable today, because it would have been very easy to just sit on my ass and play WGT all day. Doing in like my just get out here and do it. I'm kind of fortunate because LiveView, we've been playing around with a beta app, but they've just rolled out the new app. So there's features in here that I have to learn, and it's almost like it's a great reason for me to get out to the course and practice, because I want to learn what I'm capable of doing with this awesome piece of equipment and at the same time I'm actually working on my golf swing. Took a swing, drew that on because I want to make sure that's the plane, and then I'm, you know, shallowing. But in using this in the last week or so, I've noticed, you know, my swing was kind of getting pointing a little bit too far behind me, and I was like, why was that? Well, I'm just not turning enough, and this is making me pay attention to what I need to be working on, because we've got a really good move coming through the ball recently. Dan's really helped me with opening up through impact, but I guess what I've been kind of forgetting about is making sure I really complete that turn, because that gets the club exactly where we want it to be. If I'm a little short on my turn, I'm a little bit behind me, easy for me to get a little steep. So using this, I can do that, but it's got a setting now where it's like audio detected. So watch this, when I hit a shot, it's gonna basically know, it will have recorded it and play it back to me. So let's do this. So it heard it.
Now it plays it back. Boom. And then I can kind of just play around with it. And if we look, okay, cranking that turn, the club's not as pointing behind me. So then it looks shallows nicely. And then just got to turn on through. So that's one of the cool features that it
has right now, is it, I don't know how it does it, because it's basically recording what you're doing but not saving it. But when it hears impact, it knows that you've made a golf swing, so it plays it back to you. There's other features that I still need to play around with. Like, there is a mirror feature now where you can actually, I could set up like my phone here, and that can record and play to here. So it's like I can get this and this at the same time. But what I really like is how simple it is for me right now. I'm working on the same things always. Make sure the club's in a good place, it shallows, and I just turn through it. But the thing that I was forgetting was, you know, really cranking that turn on the way back. Sloppy, but not too concerned about contact. I'm concerned about that turn, and that's exactly what I want. Said earlier, like, you just have to show up. I mean, I don't have a lot of desire to like grind away on my golf swing. I'm just falling in love with hitting shots and really just focusing on my feel and my target focus, because anyone that's been watching the channel now for a bit has known that this 2019 was a mess and forgot how to play golf and just focus on a target and let my body react to that target. But if you've been watching the videos the last month or so, I'm starting to get my wedge play back, because I'm having an ability to just really dial into a target and just instinctually let it happen. And I mean, this yardage, it's a lob wedge shot, but I'm hitting it with a 54 degree just to really feel my speed and feel my body and just connect to a target, even though it's not the stock shot. And finding this creativity and just being able to stand over the ball and only think about the target, not think about my swing, has been a lot of fun. And it's just reminding me of when I was a better golfer, when I was early in my professional career and late in my amateur career. Like, wedges were just my most fun thing to practice and perform on the golf course, but then it just turned into let's play golf swing, and wedge play just started to suffer and be really inconsistent. And if your wedge play is inconsistent in professional golf, you're not making any money and you're missing a lot of cuts, and I've done my fair share of that. Moral of this story is just show up and find something that you like to do. For me, it's just having a lot of fun with my wedges. I'm wearing out the grooves on my wedges, just hitting shots 30, 40, 100, like whatever it is around the short game green. I'm just having a blast again, because showed up. Motivation's gonna come and go. Like, there's no secret. I've said that countless times. There's gonna be times we don't want it, and that's fine. That's totally fine. The weather looked crappy today. I could have just said, you know what? I'm gonna ignore my plan, ignore my one thing, and just kind of do some other stuff today and make up for it tomorrow. Well, no. Just show up, Andrew. You planned your one thing, so go and do it. And even though it's raining a little bit, you're making the most of it. And that effort is gonna pay off in droves. You're ingraining strength again, mental strength and physical strength and all of these good things. And when it comes time for like competition and when the trigger goes off again, when we're allowed to restart, you're gonna have gained a lot more than you thought. Like, the objective of this whole time on pause is about coming back stronger than ever. My advice, said it countless times in this vlog, just show up, plan it, and then just go and do it, even if you don't want to, even if you don't feel like it. You've made that appointment with yourself. You wouldn't cancel that appointment with somebody else, so don't cancel it with yourself. That's kind of the moral of the story. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. It just feels good to vlog again. It feels good to let the creative juices flow. Special episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.